إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد my dear brothers and sisters in Islam إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. In the beginning, we thanks the brothers who giving the advice all the time, and please follow the rules. Today morning, they close another masjid in Valley Stream in the month of Ramadan because the same issue, they don't follow rules. We don't need to close our masjid. We need our masjid to be open so you don't get upset. Follow the rules, inshallah. We say Alhamdulillah all the time, and we thanks Him day and night that we are here together. And when Friday, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعَ. If you hear the azan, the call for the Jumu'ah, you have to run for it and leave everything behind you. No business. But imagine this Friday is the first Friday in the best month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved, the month of the Quran, the month of the dua, the month of Ramadan. The month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He gave us the ayat of the Quran regarding the fasting, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ. In the middle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَى. He is very close to us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He asks you to make dua in the middle of the ayat of the fasting. So even these days, the days of the dua, except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's three we understand from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah will accept their dua. Al-walidin, your parents, and the traveler, al-musafir, was-sa'im, and the fasting person. This is the dua mustajab. And Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, when he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, say ameen, 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 three times. What is it? Man dhukra isma Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa lam yusalla alayhi. If you hear the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and you don't say sallallahu alayhi Muhammad, Allahumma salli wa sallim alayka ya Habibi ya Rasulullah. Wa man adraka walidayhi inda al-kibar wa lam yughfal lahu وَلَمْ يَدْخُلِ الْجَنَّةِ. The one who see their parents grow, getting older in front of him, and he never taking care of them. And the one who didn't offer the Siyam the right way. Meaning, we can fast all day, hungry, thirsty, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot accept your fasting. Backbiting, look left and right in the haram, do all the bad deeds, and you are fasting. You hurt your family member, and you are fasting. Do you think Allah will accept this fasting from you? Definitely not. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says something else too, relating to our time now. وَإِنَّ لَخَلُوفَ فَمِ الصَّائِمِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَطْيَبَ مِنْ رَأَحْتِ الْمِسْكِ. The smell of the mouth of the fasting person better عند الله, better than anything, then Allah love it. Even ra'ahat al-misk, the perfume, better than this smell. But alhamdulillah, today we're all covered. Nobody can smell our mouth anymore. We're covered by the virus. We're covered with a human being told us, put your mask on. Cover your mouth so you don't smell it anymore. Virus. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling in the Quran to follow the rules and do not follow the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sisters, cover your hair. Allah mentioned the Holy Quran. We don't want to cover. But you cover, sister, your mouth by the order of a human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is great. He's given us an example last year for all of us to follow his rules when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اجعلوا من منازلكم مساجد. Make your house as a masjid. The virus came, he let all of us make our houses masajid. We all pray last year in our houses. We make our houses masajid. Everyone put in the Facebook how they make one room as a musalla. People put a sound system. They pray with the kids and together. Great ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But who controlling all of that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now we are in the months of fasting. Is the fasting the whole scenario? No. The intention that you are praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you fast to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you stop all the bad deeds. Daily calendar, what I have to do today and tomorrow. Did I gonna pay zakah? I feed my Muslim brothers. I taking care of my sick person. I visit a sick person. I will call my parents. I will do something better. Count and download everything you did. See what you are doing better than last year. And if Allah give us more time, what we will do better next year. Life is too short. As we heard before, so many people died, old people, now they're gonna die. Today, young people die. Young people die from the virus. No one can guarantee anything. You heard about Johnson, they said they clot the blood of the people. It happened, no one can tell you what is it. Time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the transportation with the camel or the horses. The human being come with an idea daily, but this idea by intelligent people, they built cars and train and airplane and rocket and everything. Life is getting more faster, more crowded. Everything is available by the human being. But who gave them the brain for the human being? Isn't it Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is controlling all of that? But because we not question each other, this is what we are doing. We don't say alhamdulillah, Allah give us this ability to do all of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let the virus reach every single place in the earth by the transportation made by the human beings. Can you imagine that? Today they said this train is faster, 300 miles an hour and so and so. But the virus is more faster and you cannot see it. You can see the train, but you cannot see the virus. And the one who controls that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So everything made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one can control it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he created the human being. He created you. He worried about you. Because of that, he look at his human being that he just did it by subhanahu wa ta'ala, by his hand, Adam alayhi salam, and the zuriyat Adam, and the people of Adam alayhi salam. So he cared too much. Say, this is what I did, that's what I created, I'm worried about you. Maintenance, 1 month. Clean all your body, the poison inside your body, the fat in your body. I need the system which he created subhanahu wa ta'ala to be clean. So it's not punished from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today in Germany, they treat the people who are sick by fasting. After days, they treat them by the way you are doing the salah, but they say it yoga. But it's our salah.
They let them go in sujood position. So all the brain and the blood and all of that go to the head, they go to the ground. They clear them from all the headache. You, my brother, and my sisters, one time only try to go in sujood and talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tell me how long you're gonna take. Wallah, you're gonna see the best time in your life when you are down talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you make a dua for yourself and your family while you're in the sujood position. So you are in the month of fasting, the dua, the zakah, everything in this month. But we are here, wallahi, we're doing a great, great job. Some other countries, they cannot find anything, not even the prayer. They pray Salah, Isha, and the Taraweeh together in 20, 30 minutes. Give me, how are they going to finish it? But this is the rules of those countries now, and they are Muslim country. Over here, mashallah, we're doing our Jumu'ah, we're doing our Taraweeh, we enjoy our life. So we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we're still alive, we are saved. And all the ni'am, you have it today. Remember, man lam yudrik walidayhi, man adraka walidayhi inda al-kibar. The one who is in the time, his parents there with him and he's never taken care of them. Everything happened to you in this life by the barakah of your parents. Your parents is the major thing in your life. And I repeat it by the millionaire from Algeria. When they talk to him about how he became a milliardaire, you need the answer from him, all by the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, because the dua of my mother, I became a milliardaire. When I look at my mother's eyes, it gave me the whole rahmah, the whole mercy, the whole love. Because of that, I became a milliardaire. When I look at my mom, and I look at her stomach, and I see this is the womb who has carried me. Without that, I will never be this dunya. That's how I become a milliardaire. I told my mom, anytime you need anything, I am here to help you. Whatever you need is going to be in front of you. Because of that, Allah make barakah my risk and you're there. I told my mom, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me because of you. And any time Allah extend my time in this dunya is going to be under your leg, mommy. Whatever you need, it's for you. My mom is everything in my life. Because of that, I became a milliardaire. Mom, you are the queens of the dunya. I am your servant. Because of this word, I became a milliardaire. He's a human being like you and me. Same like Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu warda, how he was treating his mother perfectly. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, he was calling his mother here. Parents is the most important thing in your life, better than your fasting. In the month of Ramadan. Imagine now, you are fasting, you do zakah, you're taking care of the others, and you are very kind to your mother or your father. Many people lost their parents, and they don't have father or mother now. But still time for you now to say, I pay something for them. I will do something for them while they are in the grave. At least you make dua for them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make their grave part of the Jannah. And you make the grave lightening by your dua. And you are listening for the people who go there and visit. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. يَسْتَأْنِسُ الْمَيِّدْ بِمَنْظَارَ. The people in the grave, he will love to see his family member come over there and make dua for him. And if he's in a good shape, he call whatever with him. He say, come, my son's coming today, or my daughter, she's making dua for me. He's very happy. Except the people in very bad shape, وَالْعَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, they are worried about what's going on to them in the grave. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people who is very kind to their parents. Because today the parents are worried about later on when they get old, what will happen? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, if you have something, give it to your kids now while you are alive, so you don't fight later on. But today, they are scared. If I give them what I give, what will happen to me after? I will be in the nursing home, and nobody care about me. As we all know the story about the woman, when her son visit her, he say, Mom, what do you need? She said, I don't need anything. I'm in the nursing home. If you want to bring something, bring a refrigerator so I can put food on it. He said, Mom, but it's a nursing home. She said, Son, this is the only thing I have. When I was home, I was looking for a piece of bread, and you don't have it because you are busy in your life. You come when I'm sleeping. You leave when I'm sleeping. Nursing home, people taking care of me, but the refrigerator is empty. We need a refrigerator, we need some food there. People in nursing home, they die, and the family member, they don't know anything about them. Unless they call them, say, come. He passed away, she passed away, come and take the body. It happened, brothers. It happened. That's why today in the dunya, parents are scared to give the wealth to the kids, which is the sunnah to give. While you are alive, at least write it and say, give it to them after I'm passed away. So you hold it, because no one know what the kids will do later on. Give your zakah by your hand, the sadaqah by your hand, sadaqah jariyah, make sadaqah jariyah. Yes, the masajid today, they need your help. Today, how many people in the salah? The masajid is non-profit organization, depend on your the donation or the whatever come from you to the masjid. Today, they don't have this much. They need help. Before I come here, was fundraising in Chicago, one of the masajids. Before I come, already they collect 4.1 million. 4.1 million. Brother asking for 75,000. Big difference. Because people now, they don't care about the dunya much. The money in the bank, you wouldn't know if you're going to go there to get it or not. We're going to leave everything behind. And you leave it for your kids. Imagine, your kids, alhamdulillah, is very generous. And he take the money, his wealth, and he donate after that. He is the only one get the good deed, but you not. Because you are stingy in the dunya. The dua we always said in Ramadan, Allahumma ati munfiqan khalafa. Oh Allah, the one who give him more. وَعَتِ مُمْسِكًا تَلَفَ. The one who is holding his man like that, oh Allah, let him away from us. We don't need these people. Because in these days, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ وَصُفِّدَتِ الشَّيَاطِينِ. The gate of the Jannah all open. And the gate of hellfire, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala closed it. And he chained the shayateen. But what we have today is the shayateen of the dunya, our own. Our own. Don't be stingy. The fires give us a beautiful lesson. No one can guarantee anything in this dunya. No house, no money, no wife, no son. And that's what Allah said in the Holy Quran. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعْ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. They will not, nothing will help you at all. Except that we come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pure heart, beautiful heart. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وسائر المؤمنين. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, when we talk about fasting and the relation with the parents, which one becoming more important? Really is hurting me personally badly when we see a lot of parents in very bad shape because of their kids, because they cannot see a mercy and kind and love for the kids. They work very hard for them. By the time they grow a little bit, they ignore their parents, running because the dunya is more important than their parents. لَن تَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةِ إِذَا كُنْتَ عَاقًا لِوَالِدَيْكِ. You will never enter the Jannah if you disobey your parents. Allah mentioned them in the Holy Quran after him, سُبْحَانَ وَتَعَالَى وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. إِمَّا يَبْلُغَنَّ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا. يَبْلُغَ عِنْدَكَ الْكِبَرَ, when you get an old, أَحَدُهُمَا أَوْ كِلَاهُمَا, one of them or both, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا. So make the Shahr of Ramadan the month of Rahmah. You get closer to your parents. Go closer to them. Make dua for them. Ask them if they need any help. Wallahi, if they are millionaires and you give little bit, whatever you give is better than what they have. Better than what they have, I'm telling you. When I was in Egypt, I spoke to my mom. I say, Mom, your daughter come all the time here. Did you give her something? You didn't need the money, Mom. She say, why I give her? She has her own income. I say, can you try? Just give a little bit. 500 is not gonna hurt. I will send you this money for you behind her. Last week when I spoke to my brother, he say, your mom give some money for your sister. Oh my God. The following day in the morning, she was in the house, give her a hug and kiss, and this money for her like the whole wallet. You see, small thing, you can do it. It can clear a lot of problems. Because today, my family and your family is all same. I'm not saying I'm something better than anyone. No, we're all same thing. Brother and sister, they look at each other. Mom, do you give my brother some? She say, yeah, because he has three kids. What about your daughter? She don't need it. Her kids get married already. See how it is? Little money can solve all this problem. Call the brother, he call her, mom in the middle, because a little bit. Money is our problem in this dunya. يَوْمَ لَيَنْفَعْ مَالٌ مَال, مال, money, money. Allah mentioned all the time, money. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because of that, he said, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً. The people who spend their money day and night, secret and loud, those are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't worry about them in the day of judgment. They are in the Jannah right away. And the people who make spend the money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا يَتَّبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنًّا وَلَا أَذَى. They don't follow what they give. And they don't say, I am, I give, I give, I give. Those people, لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Don't worry about those people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows our heart is linked with the money and our kids. But the kids will grow. You don't know what they will do with you. The money, same thing. You know, taken with you. So we are in the time of the month of Ramadan, month of Rahmah. I know so many shaykh spoke about the fasting and the rule of the fasting and the sadaqah and the zakah and all of that. But I love to mention the parents, because in my position as leading prayers, phone calls non-stop. Fighting between parents and the kids all the time. Police get involved in the middle. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, it's very bad for all of us as a believers who's in La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah and who hurt our parents. وَإِذْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا تَعْبُدُونَ إِلَّا اللَّهَ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your parents. So it's not the fasting. Fasting is just to purify your body and purify your deen, and you obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But again, put your parents in front of you. This is the line. You can go directly to the Jannah, inshallah. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the people who are taking care of the parents and fasting the right way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to us. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting and our salah. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat, al muslimina wal muslimat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Allahumma aghfir lana adh-dhunuba, kaffir 'anna sayyi'at. Nahmaduka ya rabbana wa nashkuruk على أن جعلتنا في هذه الأيام نصوم شهر رمضان ونجتمع في شهر رمضان ونقرأ القرآن في شهرك الكريم ونكون وراء شيوخك يا أكرم الأكرمين ونسمع من شيوخك يا كريم. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك, خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك ما استطعت. نسألك الجنة ونعيمها ونعوذ بك من النار وشرورها. ونعوذ بك يا ربنا من النار وشرورها. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين تغفر لهم الذنوب في هذا الشهر العظيم. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا جميعا. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا. اللهم ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغارا.
اللهم نسألك يا ربنا أن ترزقنا شربة ماء من يد رسولك الكريم لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من النار يا كريم، اجعلنا من عبادك المغفورين المرحومين المقبولين. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وتقبل صلاتنا وركوعنا وسجودنا يا كريم. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين، وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله، رحمني ورحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة.